10 seconds remaining. Radiant team, ban.
Okay, hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Game 2 here in the best of 5 between Team Empire and Team Secret here at the Mars TV Dota 2 League Finals. For this game, you will be joined by Gods and Winter. Gods, are you there?
I'm here, how are you doing?
Winter, are you there?
What's up?
There we go, I'd like to introduce you two to each other, and I'm going to take a steep back, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm going to let Gods and Winter get on with it. So lads and ladies, take it away for the beautiful viewers at home.
Wow, man. Odie, you're like Cupid here, putting us together after we've been separated for so long. Winter, how are you, buddy?
I'm good. Been a while. What?
It has been a while. We've finally reunited here in the casting seat, and we've got Empire vs. Secret, Game 1 going Secret's way. Game 2, we'll see what Team Empire have in store for us. This time around, they do ban out the IO, so we won't see Secret getting the IO Bristleback they had in Game 1, and we'll see what they have in store here with Game 2 draft. Undying still in the pool, probably the big hero that Empire let slip through a bit further with their first big shadow theme.
I think it's better to just leave Undying compared to the Whis or the Tusk. I think Secret used these two heroes much better than the way they played Undying. I think you have a much better chance of beating them if you give them Undying compared to the Whis or the Tusk. And this time around, Empire having first pick definitely helpful as well, because it allows them to ban an extra Chen, because Secret doesn't want to give the Tusk away to Empire as well. So they are able to open a draft with a Shadow Fiend.
Well, Secret start things off with the Zai Clockwork, which has been a go-to every now and then, but not normally been a first pick for Secret, so interesting that they actually prioritize this into the first pick slot.
Yeah, probably because like Clockwork, you can fit the hero into any sort of strategy, so you want to keep things open so you don't tie yourself down into having to go into a certain way of playstyle. So definitely if you look at Empire's hero, they just pick only Shadow Fiend, doesn't give away anything, so you don't want to give away anything yourself. So Clockwork during the mid game, good versus the Shadow Fiend, I say quite decent if you sort of get a hit. And Clockwork's one of the few heroes that can initiate onto the Shadow Fiend fairly easily in fights.
Yeah, just kind of surprised. Normally Secret just insta first pick that Queen of Pain when it's available, but
they're really thinking about it.
Yeah, still there if they want to get it as their second pick, but the fact they're taking this long means they at least are considering other options, although they still may go back for the Queen of Pain.
Maybe they would go for the Kotal, though. Usually when they have Clock, they have Kotal in tandem with the Clock, and they... Oh no, there's actually still... Yeah, I forgot about this hero as well. There's still Leshrac in the pool. One of the heroes that are constantly pick and ban as well. I think this one and Queen of Pain are both the heroes that are always pick and ban at the moment. With the Tusk, especially in this event.
It's funny how each like event has its own metagame. This event, it was all about Tusk. Tusk suddenly became top pick, top ban. When leading up to this, it was like a very situational fringe pick from a team hero there, but this tournament, the hero just blew up. Every tournament seems to develop its own kind of set of heroes that teams prioritize.
Yeah, definitely. Every tournament a different meta, and but Tusk is proven to be like one of the really strong heroes without items, obviously, in this event, because his spells are really good, and you don't exactly need much farm on the hero to be able to do your job very well. So I would say he's a very, very good utility hero, to put it that way.
And Empire, speaking of kind of go-to heroes, the Disruptor gets second picked by them, something that they be running a lot, I mean, throughout MDL, as well as going back to like the D2CL, just a support they really value in their lineup. And it doesn't really, I mean, it's kind of nice against the Clockwork because you can glimpse him out of his cogs after he initiates in, but it's not like you could just get something like a Rubick if you wanted that same purpose as well. It seems to be just a hero that Empire really value for the strong laning presence. Thunderstrike at level 1, a fantastic spell. Lots of great setup potential coming out from the Glimpse kinetic field as well, so gives them a lot of control in these early to mid-game engagements.
Yeah, and Secret in their ban, they took out the AA, so it might actually mean they want to try they might want to try to push because they have Leshra on their side as well. And taking out the aim might actually sound the alarm that towards Empire that Secret want to do something very aggressive with push strategy. Because A is one of the better heroes to defend against a push early.
Yeah. Are they going to get some kind of mech buyer then, or like some kind of heal slash sustain with one of their next
maybe you want to get a healing hero as well, but yeah. I'm thinking of what type of hero that's afraid of A. It's like, maybe a core that's afraid of A is probably Alchemist. I haven't seen Secret use that hero.
Yeah, even like Morphling has not really ever been picked up by Secret as well, so... Not sure what they have in mind. It is, I mean, AA is a hero that Empire go towards when they're running, like, maybe an aggro trial lane with a Disruptor AA plus one, or just, they'll run it even in the defensive lane as well, so maybe just something they just don't want to mess around with, so. Interesting. We'll see Secret now. Third pick, Razor. There's your mech buyer, I imagine. You mentioned pushing, and this will probably be built around that.
Yeah, they're gonna have, I would imagine the Lashrock would actually be the solo mid hero if they want to be pushing early, so you give the hero much more levels and farm, so he's able to take down towers much faster. And Razor is a hero that Secret tends to lane him anywhere. Like, we've seen like one or two games on the offlane Razor plus one hero, like Razor plus Witch Doctor or Razor plus a support, and sometimes it's on the safe lane. So this is a very flexible pick for Secret. You don't know where they're going to lane the hero, and sometimes he goes mid as well.
Yeah. Do you think there's much of a chance that they run Leshrac as a support here, or is this going to probably be a core Leshrac?
If they want to push, it's going to be most likely a core Leshrac. If they feel that things are not going to be so favorable for a pushing lineup, they can always switch the Lesh towards the support role, because that's the beauty of the Lesh, right? He's so flexible. You can pick him up very early, and it doesn't define what strategy you're going to move into. You can just basically do anything you want with the hero.
Yep. Well, we'll see what Empire have in mind for their third and fourth pick now. They've got the Disruptor Shadow Fiend, and need to start putting the rest of the pieces together with these next couple of picks, and start with a Vengeful Spirit. So, pretty standard support, and decent against the Clockwork. If the Clockwork hookshot initiates on someone like a Shadow Fiend, you can save him with the swap, yeah.
And so, a lot of Roche potential there on the Dire side with the Shadow Fiend, so all in all, it's a pretty good lineup that like has a lot of synergy. Empire used to run like a minus armor lineup, right? With Slaughter plus Shadow Fiend. I remember like it was recently, maybe last month, they have Slaughter plus Shadow Fiend together as their cores on Dire side. So that might be something that they want to look to do. It's very good against Leshrac though. If he's always standing in front and just with one amplified damage, you can kill him very easily.
Yeah, they have a ton of physical damage. And minus armor already with Venge and SF, so getting a physical damage safe lane farmer definitely makes sense here. Even if it's not just, like, a Slaughter gives you more minus armor and some physical damage, but even if it's just something like a Jug or whatever in the safe lane, it makes a lot of sense with the Venge and Shadow Fiend pickups.
Yeah, something that can utilize the Rosh or something along the lines with a lot of physical damage, definitely. And Secret, so far, I think their lanes are still very flexible. For Empire, it's mostly the Shadow Fiend going mid. They know the Shadow Fiend is going to go mid, so they can either put like Lash or Razor. I think either of these heroes do very well, like fairly well against Shadow Fiend. I think Razor would be able to put more pressure, but Leshrac would open more gank potentials for the Shadow for his team against the Shadow Fiend, since he can set things up with a Lightning Storm to slow before the supports come in. So it's going to be a greedy support for Secret. They're going to be utilizing the jungle since they feel that Empire support, like Disruptor, you want to sit in the lane and get levels early. So he's not a very aggressive support, he's more of like a babysitter in the lane, and he gets the pull going and getting more experience for himself. Yeah. So Secret think that they can get away with a much greedier support on their own.
Yeah, I mean, both teams going fairly, I mean, Empire themselves will be playing fairly greedy, at least they have support with more lane presence, but Storm Spirit as a fourth pick gives them what I imagine is going to be their safe lane farmer. So they're going to have Storm looking to farm the lane, do what he can there, and Shadow Fiend as a core is just going to be looking to fall back into the jungle when possible. We're not going to see a lot of aggression coming out from Empire either. Maybe a smoke gank here or there towards the mid if it's someone like a Leshrac or a Razor, but I don't see them really pressuring early towers so much here.
Yeah, I think the Venge early game would be, because like you mentioned, the Disruptor is going to be in the lane, very good at zoning out offlane with the Thunderstrike level 1, so it's going to free up a lot of space for the Venge to go roam and stack for, especially the Shadow Fiend. They might even go like level 1 with the house, so you can actually double stack and give the Shadow Fiend much more jungle camps later in the game. So, I mean, Empire can play as much as greedy as the Enigma pick on Secret, I'd say, with the Venge constantly stacking.
One of the nice things about the Venge is you do have that counter to the BKB black hole later on in the game, but still, I mean, laning-wise and just greed-wise, it suits Secret and what they can get away with. They do ban out Naga Siren, so to prevent that Song plus black hole combo. And Secret, speaking of greed, last pick a Bounty Hunter. They effectively have no real laning supports here. Bounty Hunter is going to be the closest thing to that, and this is going to be the Kuro Bounty, I imagine.
I mean, because they are going to do the laning Razor safe lane. So Razor, basically, he's able to take care of himself. He doesn't need a support compared to maybe like something like a Luna or some other lane carry. So Razor would open up the space for the supports to do whatever they want. In this case, because the enemy team has Shadowfiend and Storm, two heroes that utilizes jungle very well. And when you have a Bounty Hunter versus that, you're going to be able to scout or place deep observer wards and give vision to your team whenever they are doing their stacks, and you probably can set up stuff for your, especially at your Clockwork, to come in and maybe snag a kill when the Shadowfiend is low or the Storm Spirit is low. So the Bounty Hunter there definitely have a lot of potential in a game like this.
Are the heroes that come to mind that Empire could consider picking up for Yoku to have a really good 1v1 matchup against the Razor? Brood,
I think,
perhaps?
They...
Or, I mean, he doesn't play a lot of Brood.
Brood
but...
is actually pretty good here, quite good against the enemy, because the enemy has Bounty and Enigma, which does nothing against Brood. But I don't think I've seen Empire run Brood. So
I think I've seen
sure.
one game Empire ran Brood, but it was quite a while ago, so it's not
They don't usually like to play that hero very much on the offlane. He's mostly on like Earthshaker or Sand King offlane, like Axe or initiating heroes on the offlane. But this game they need an offlane that this one would be fairly decent against Razor, since you can spam the wave with double Iron Shell and probably get some farm compared to other offlaners, because usually against Razor
normal...
you're not going to get so much farm.
Yeah, his normal Earthshaker Sand King type offlaners don't work, because that's where you get Static Link, you can't last hit. Darkseer can last hit with Iron Shell, so this is where you've got a match. It at least works with the Darkseer as far as he can farm.
Yeah.
Razor should be able to get some decent farm as well, though.
The thing I'm worried about the Darkseer is because Darkseer is a hero that utilizes jungle. So if you look at their lineup, Shadowfiend, Storm, and Darkseer, three of these cores would definitely want to have some sort of access towards their jungle. Unless Darkseer has a good start, he's going to be able to stand at bottom lane and he uses the enemy jungle. But I think it's going to be a lot harder for Darkseer to use the enemy jungle, since you're going to most likely run into the Enigma, that's number one. And you probably get harassed by the Razor a lot in the lane, and you won't be a good amount of HP when you're trying to jungle. So it's pretty risky if you don't see the Bounty and the Enigma on the maps, and you run into the enemy jungle trying to farm their jungle. So
yeah,
I'm not sure whether the Darkseid will get a good time in the early game, but we'll see.
Okay, we'll see how things go. It's going to be, as kind of mentioned, Resolution. It will be just going mid on the Shadow Fiend. So pretty standard laning setup from Team Empire, and we'll see what Secret have in mind. But I don't imagine we see any crazy deviations coming out from them. Zaya's picked up Clockwork. Actually gone Boots first on Clock here as he marches his way towards the Radiant Jungle. This is where you want to make sure you scout out those Observers and Sentries that are trying to block the Enigma Jungle camps.
Usually you start with Boots if you know you're for sure against a Tri-lane. That's what I feel like. Boots will enable you to get out of the potential. Like, Glimpse at level 1 is really short range, so having the Boots might be a difference of life and death in this lane. So they're going to place Observer Ward here, so it's going to give them some Ruin Vision. And Empire is actually going to place a middle lane ward, and they gave the Shadowfiend a Sentry as well, so it's important for the Shadowfiend. I remember him having a Sentry just now. Where
on the
did
Kareem?
It go?
It's just put behind the Tier 1 Talon mid, yeah.
Yeah, it's so very important to have sentries for the mid lane against a Bounty Hunter early on. That's very crucial.
Oh yeah, I mean, Bounty hits level 2, you get the Janata slow, and with a less track, there is a lot of kill potential in this mid lane, so... We'll see Resolution looking to go for this top level 1 Bounty Room, but here comes Secret with 3 heroes in stock. They want to go in for the kill.
He's
Resolution
dead.
Gets hit by the stun, and the Cogs is zoning out the rest of the heroes. Resolution gets the... Well, killed off by the Lestrek, who gets the first blood. Bounty Room did go the way... Team Secret, but it's not really worth it in there. They're going to lose the Bounty Hunter and return Secret. Push back. Arteezy looking for one more on the Disruptor, but not going to get it. It's one for one trade. Secret getting the Bounty Runes as well as First Blood onto Arteezy. Great start for the Lestrak.
They got both the Bounty Runes, in fact. So that was a huge, huge win for Secret in the first engagement there. And the lanes would be... I mean, Clockwork, I guess he has to... Yeah, he's going to suicide and come back into the lane, so... He's going to be there fairly soon, and Kuroki with the Ult of Venom, I think he will be a lot of he'll be dealing a lot of pressure towards the Shadow Fiend in the early game with that Orb of Venom.
Yeah. Well, this is gonna be interesting to see how these lanes kind of work out here. It looks like we'll have Clockwork with some assistance at top lane. Bounty Hunter Kuro is up there helping things out a bit. As looking to make sure that Zai doesn't get completely bullied out of this lane. Kuro's even kind of contesting these pulls here on the Dire pull camp.
He's gonna be stealing some valuable experience away from especially the Disruptor, which is a support that relies superly a lot on experience early on. And Kuroki, he's gonna be spotted by a Sentry there, but the Clockwork actually managing to kill the Storm alone. Before that, it was like he got two bounces of the cogs on the Storm, which was huge, but I didn't expect him to get the kill there. So that's just a really good misplay.
Absolutely. I was watching the Bounty Hunter get chased around by the supports, and suddenly it's like, oh, Clockwork just solo killed the Storm Spirit. A lot of that goes back to the Bounty Hunter and the space he just created, so we'll see. It looks like the Courier coming out with the bottle. Vengeful Spirit is going to attach this to the mid lane. Kuro trying to come in for the kill. Resolution down to just one hit. Arteezy wants this second kill. He's going to get it. Maybe pay for it with his life. We get the tower aggro off of him. Great play from Arteezy. Gets the kill, gets tower aggro off of him, and escapes with his life. Kuro almost going down as well there with the flank, but that is a big pickup for Arteezy. His mid lane dominance continues.
The early game is going fantastic for Team Secret. Just right from the bounty runes till the laning phase, the Clockwork getting a solo kill on the Storm. I mean, everything seems to be going their way. And on top of that, don't forget they have a jungling Enigma.
Yeah. No wards in his jungle as well. Nothing has been blocked off. This is completely free and open jungle. It's not quite as fast top lane. Meanwhile, Zai going in, he's gonna get a fight into Silent. They actually TP Arteezy up here. Arteezy rotated with the help of Kuro. It looks like they're gonna get a couple of kills to go their way. Both Disruptor.
Things are looking from bad to worse for them. I mean, the Enigma is gonna come online in. He usually reaches level 6 at 4 minutes around that mark, 4 minute 10 seconds or 4:20, and that's going to be the time he's going to look to use his black hole on a key target. I mean, this is all happening without the Enigma participating in anything at all, so things are definitely looking super good for Secret from the start. And Echo obviously getting farm as well on the bottom lane. Darkseer has actually managed a lot of losses late, okay, didn't notice that. 13 to 14 of S4. He doesn't have regen left, so he's gonna have trouble in the lane for the Razor. He doesn't have any tangles left anymore. I think he's gonna want to prioritize the first Darkseer, because if you look at all their heroes, the Darkseer is probably one of the heroes you want to shut down early. Top lane as well. Yeah, the Clockwork, once the Clockwork and now the Bounty Hunter. And bottom lane, S4 is getting dove by the Darkseer. He's gonna get very low, but Enigma's gonna have his black hole up, so let's see if he wants to help up the bottom lane first or try to get a black hole. I think the two biggest target right now is that either he goes for the Shadow Fiend kill or he gets the Darkseer kill here with the black hole. Oh, middle. Wow. And that's like the of one level of Pulse Nova. Killed the Venge, got his level 6, he took Pulse Nova and he just did Shadow Fiend from there. That was so much damage done in a short period of time. And all the lanes going very well. I'd say the only person having like the best time right now is probably Storm. He has the most Darkseid, but he has 2 deaths, so probably Darkseid is the one that... See, looking at the net worth, the highest net worth here is Storm on the Dire Strike, like, having the best time, man. Invis rune gonna be picked up by the Disruptor. Probably going to try and set up something, but it's not gonna be easy though, he's just only level 4. Did he get a smoke? Bounty Hunter, he's Arcane Boots very early on, level 5. So this is going to be a very fast level 6 Bounty Hunter this game. They're going to get a kill here, but Silent doesn't have a lot of mana. But he still has his Soul Ring here, he still has Soul Ring. Empire's making a smoke movement towards middle, but Leshrog's all the way back to base and he's gonna TP top, give his teammates some bottle charges, and they're gonna try and probably kill the Storm here. Storm is in a very precarious position. He has very little mana as well, so it's gonna be very easy for them to kill him. I mean, they got the Storm and they couldn't fight with the rest of the heroes, so Empire with the glimpse on the clockwork managing to get away. And looking at the jungle, they have some huge stack here. I'm not sure if the bounty scouted that out earlier, because they can actually try to steal it with the Lash, both with nukes, if they actually scout this stack out. Not sure if they saw it. Yeah, but we are not the only ones lagging apparently. They just look at the net worth, like everyone on Secret side has managed to get farm, whereas if you look at Empire, the Venge is like 500 net worth right now, so that's looking really bad for them. Track is gonna come, I'd say in a minute or so, if they decide, they can actually leave the middle lane right now for the bounty, and the left shot can maybe just move around and try to set up kills or do some jungling. If the Enigma wants to move and push towers, maybe they... Yeah, I think it's probably the best time right now for them to give Bounty like one or two. He needs, I guess, 2 waves of creeps to get his track. So then he's gonna be a huge force for Secret. Because his track is gonna come at tops 9 or 10 minutes. It's gonna be a very early track. Yeah, this is usually like, it's like a skill build where you choose to go for just for total lane dominance, like it's just for the lane. I guess it's good versus Razor so you can get away, but I'm not sure if you want so many points like you mentioned. If they're gonna fight early, because Secret is on a very good early game, they might want to push very early, and your Darkseid not having any points in Vacuum and Wall would mean that you are not gonna be able to defend the push because you don't have your key abilities up. bottom lane. They have to get this kill if they want to go. They must get this kill. That's like a 9-minute godlike streak. Leshrac with like so, he's gonna have like a very early soul boost. I mean a blood very early. This is gonna be a very scary Leshrac. Kuroki, he is really really close to his level 6. This is gonna be a time where Seeker are gonna try and look for a few kills with his track and hopefully snowball from that.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah. They are going to get the Venge most likely, I guess, with the track here. They smoked up and they are going back in. They saw him running into the trees.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
They're probably still gonna get the tower though, even without any points in the edict here. And the caller should be able to secure the top tower. Who's gonna build the mech anyway? They both have headdress. The Razor has a headdress. Okay, Razor's gonna build the headdress. The mech. Pipe doesn't feel super it's good there was a Shadow Fiend, I guess. That would probably be an option they want to. I think he gets it depending on situation. If they can look to push and end the game early, he might want to go for it. Otherwise, he would just go for maybe other items. Like maybe Necrobook. Necrobook could be a good pickup here against the Storm.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
So the Darkseid is gonna build into an early pipe and SF is gonna finish the mech on Empire, but they're gonna lose the tier 1 middle. Zai is coming and the Bounty Hunter is just doing so much work this game. With the tracks and the bouncing Shuriken toss, he's doing so much damage in teamfight.
Radiant's
Well, they didn't get kills, but they got like tracks on everyone, and everyone was really low. Only one bench though. Only one wench kill. The Tower Wolf defended by Empire with the wall, but here comes Secret again. Flawless. They're gonna get a kill on the Disruptor right from the start without with just using a hookshot and Midnight Pulse. No major spells used. Black Hole is gonna come off cooldown in a long time, still 1 minute, 110 seconds of that, but it doesn't seem like they're gonna be needing the Black Hole for this tier 2 tower. Yeah, but things not looking good for Empire right now. Yeah, so both the teams will have a fairly early pipe. Darkseid is also building one, so it's gonna be mech and pipe very early for both the teams. But I still think like Empire, they still have what it takes to win a team fight if they land a combo, like the vacuum into Raccoon Muscles with the wall, if they can actually do that. But without the dagger, it's not gonna be easy, and they're gonna try and get a glimpse here with Aloha Dance. Just Secret just moving around the map better and using, I mean, every time you lose a fight against Bounty with track, it's gonna put you in such a bad position. And Empire, after that fight, I think the next fight they'll be back home, so even if you land a very good combination, there's still a black hole to worry about. And Storm is gonna find Kuroki again. Consolation kill maybe? No. Probably gonna die. Yeah, he's gonna die. That was a really, really good trade off for Secret at the end of the day, giving away the bounty, but track on three heroes like you mentioned, with the Storm dying there. And Derry. No, unless he, no, I don't think he gets the kill if he's not in the AoE. He only gets like kill if he gets the last hit, like the bonus goal. Yeah, I know, if only you get the last hit. If only you get the last hit. Must be the one getting the last hits. Then you get the bonus goal for self. The first one, the self bonus goal. The bounties as far as like all their costs. That's how bad the situation is right now. Why not against the Storm? Thank you. Yeah, I think you just need the BKB. It's like Glashrock. All the spells Glashrock has, I mean, you need the BKB no matter what. Yeah, but I mean, they're in a very bad situation now, so he kind of has to do it, I think. Otherwise, he wouldn't be able to do anything in fights. I think only one? I'm not sure. I think I saw one only. I'm not sure. Maybe two. I'm not sure. If you check the team fight recap, it only shows like one track. Not sure why. But I think I saw two. This is definitely not looking good for Empire. They kind of can't even fight right now because they are too far behind. I think even if they get a super good combo, like you vacuum into the Disruptor ulti and kinetic shield, they might still lose the fight from the mech and the pipe and everything else. Like, you can't kill the Lashrock, I think. If you have to throw everything on the Lashrock, his teammates is gonna kill all of you. Because the Lashrock is way too tanky right now. 1.6k HP. He can basically tank the Disruptor's ulti and the Requiem. Do they have the BKB? Oh, he's still lacking the recipe, so if Secret decides to go high ground now, he doesn't have BKB for the defense. What's new? So Secret is gonna be sieging the base and Empire doesn't have a blink. Oh, they're gonna hook and kill the Storm Spirit with the Orchid on the Clockwork, so he did not expect that at all. And Secret's gonna just continue to siege the base with the track on resolution. A speed up to follow things up. The Vacuum then not gonna do so much, only catching one hero, and Puffy is gonna try and run up and threaten to use his Black Hole even though it was still on cooldown. But everyone is running away from Puffy in fear of the incoming Black Hole, and Ace is gonna be popped by the Last Shark here. Okay, he's suicides and he's up. Oh, he's gonna get glimpsed Black Hole! Man, that toss, the shuriken toss. Yeah, this game is getting out of reach for Empire now. Getting way out of reach. Without a BKB, the Shadow Fiend can't dish out damage in fights, so I think this game is pretty much in the bags for Secret. They're gonna finish up the second set of racks and Roshan is gonna be like in another 4 minutes, I guess. This very good drafting from mainly Secret, because like, you remember the way they opened the draft? They opened up with Shadowfiend, and they picked up Venge, and they opened Shadowfiend plus